You have already learned about Google My Maps and I have shown you how to set markers on your own map. Today, I want to show you how to plan a route in Google My Maps. You can later use this route for navigation on a GPS device or in a navigation app like Komoot. Hello, my name is Thomas. I am your auto tech instructor. I'm your expert in auto navigation, fitness apps and trackers. These are the chapters of this video: creating a route, editing a route and export the route. You can create routes in Google My Maps. You will find the tool for this at the top of the toolbar under the search bar. When you click on Add Directions, Google My Maps creates a new layer. A route must always have its own layer. You can give the layer a name. The routing profile can be driving, cycling, and walking. This will later determine which path may be used for routing. Below this, you will find the first two routing points with A and B. We will define places as routing points that you have set as markers on your map. A total of 10 routing points are available for planning. In addition, you can change the route even further. Let's first set the starting point A. We used the map from a previous exercise and want to plan a road trip. Therefore, I leave the routing profile at driving. The starting point should be Cleveland. First, click in the text field behind routing point A and then on the marker Cleveland on the map. Then click on Boston. Google My Maps creates a route. To extend the route by another point, click on Add Destination and then select the marker New York. The route now has 3 points. Repeat the process with the remaining markers on the map. For the last destination, select Cleveland again, where the road trip started. Now we have set all 10 possible routing points and cannot create any more. In the next chapter, I will show you how to edit the route. Do you already have experience with Google My Maps? What do you use Google My Maps for? I look forward to your comments. Please support me by subscribing to my channel and activating the bell. That way you'll never miss a new video on my channel. A created route can also be edited. Routing points can be deleted, changed, or rearranged. In addition, the course of the route can be changed without changing the routing points. First, we want to remove a routing point. To do this, move the mouse over the route point B, Boston, in the route layer. A pencil and an X symbol appear behind the routing point. Click on the X to delete the route point. Google My Maps adjusts the route. Go back to the route layer via point B. New York has now moved up there. Click on the pencil and then click on the Boston marker on the map. You have now changed the destination for routing point B to Boston. You can also delete the name of the routing point and enter a place as a destination. Google My Maps offers assistance with this via autocomplete. We want to bring New York back into the road trip as a routing point. Click on Add Destination and then click on the New York marker in the map. Now the route looks a bit messed up. New York should move behind Boston as a next destination, but at the moment New York is at the end of the route. In the route layer, move the mouse over New York. Hold down the left mouse button and move the cursor over point C where New York is to be placed again. Then release the mouse button. We have now adjusted the order of the routing points and Google My Maps has recalculated the route. Before I show you how you can use the route later, I will show you a way to change the course of the route between two routing points. The fact that you cannot add any more routing points is not a problem. On the way from Richmond to Myrtle Beach, we want to make a detour to Charlotte. To do this, move the cursor on the map over the route between Richmond and Myrtle Beach. A white dot will now appear on the route. Click the left mouse button and keep it present. Now drag the cursor to the desired stopover. You can scroll over the stop by holding down the mouse button and zooming in and out with the mouse wheel. Release the mouse button at the intermediate stop. Google My Maps will now recalculate the route via this point. You can create furthermore points in this way and thus edit the route. You can move this point again and placing the cursor directly over a point and moving it while holding down the left mouse button. The point is deleted when you click on it once. Now you have learned how to create a route and how to customize it according to your wishes. You can use the route as a design element on your map. You can also export it to use it directly for navigation. More on this in a moment. I show you how to create markers in Google My Maps in the video at the top right. As always, you can find the link in the video description. Would you like to see a tutorial on a topic that moves you? Then comment below this video which tutorial you would like me to create. If you would like to use the Planet Route for navigation, unfortunately you cannot use Google Maps. You can export the route to use it on a GPS device or in an app like Komoot. Remember the name of the route layer, then go to the menu of the map to the three dots next to the map name. Click on it and then select Export to KML, KMZ. In the next step, select the route layer of the route you just planned and click Download. You will now find the KML file in your download folder. Some apps or GPS devices do not support the KML file format. In this case, you can convert the KML file into a GPX file, for example. All trails offer such a converter. GPS Babel is an app that you need to install on your desktop. Garmin Basecamp also supports a conversion of various formats. I sometimes use Google My Maps to plan routes that are not on the Komoot map. I showed you how to import the file into Komoot after conversion in one of my Komoot videos. You can find even more tutorials for Google My Maps in the playlist at the top left. I'll show you the full power of Komoot in the playlist at the bottom left. I'm Thomas, your AutoTech instructor, and I'd be happy if you show other users if you like this tutorial. I'm happy about the comment and the thumbs up. See you next time.